joy or happiness, success or failure, peace or dismay. The foundations of our life rest on the words we receive. A word of hope and guidance, translated from the Temple of Solomon in Brazil. You're listening to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Univere Video is your platform for Christian content, and it gives you access to the church meetings of the Universal Church around the world, and they are in English. Even the meetings at the Temple of Solomon that provide live, simultaneous translations to English. All you have to do is sign up, and this is how. Visit www.univerevideo.com online or download the application on your mobile device and complete the simple registration form. Have your bank card ready and choose your terms of payment. And before you know it, you'll be up and running. Stay connected to the things of faith during the 21 days fast of Daniel.
My friends, may God bless each and every one of you, directing your thoughts, your understanding, your heart, your intellect, and so on, giving your spirit, your intelligence, the ability to comprehend His holy word, and once it is understood, then it can be applied in your life, and consequently, you will reap the wonderful results of it. So this Sunday, we are going to have the Sunday of Peace in all the universal churches of the Kingdom of God. And when we speak of peace, obviously this peace is or would be impossible to have if there is no faith. Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ is what promotes peace. Think with me. If a criminal is caught in the act and he is taken before the judge to be judged, so there are witnesses, eyewitnesses to what he did, showing that he is guilty. He indeed committed a crime, and before the witnesses, he obviously knows that he will be condemned. However, because of this condemnation that he already foresees, he already knows he's going to be condemned, then because of that, he has no peace. He is restless, worried, anxious, nervous. He is in agony before the sentence is given, because he knows that he will be condemned. He doesn't know how many years the sentence will be, but he knows that he will be condemned. Well, you can imagine then a person who carries within themselves the guilt of their sins, the hidden sins, the sins that are within themselves, in the heart, grudges, resentment, jealousy, lusts, vanity, and so on. They carry these sins and this guilt within themselves, and to top it off, they have also did what they shouldn't have done. They were unfair with other people, and so on. So they carry a bunch of guilt, of sins, which are liable to eternal condemnation before God. That's the reality. When the person, as long as the person is carrying the guilt of their mistakes and their wrongdoings in life, then they will have no peace. Because whatever is the reason why the person feels guilty, they are not in peace anymore. Unless the judge is the Father of the Lord, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is our solicitor. So Jesus is the solicitor of those who trust in Him, those who listen and obey His word. Not just believe in a way, oh, I say I believe in Jesus. No, it's to believe and follow His word, His steps, His footsteps, and to follow His direction. This is to believe. So when the person is full of sins, but they surrender their life to the Lord Jesus Christ and they trust in Him, they believe that He is the forgiver, believes that He is the Savior, the Redeemer, then that person, because of this faith, this belief, then they receive peace. Why do they receive peace? Even though they were doing wrong and made many mistakes, why do they receive peace? Because the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, the Spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, confirms within that person that all of their guilt and sins were washed in the blood of the Lord Jesus. So when the person has this confirmation within themselves, only they, it's them and God, God and them, and no one can interfere. They know they were justified. They know that they were forgiven. They know that the Lord Jesus, as their solicitor, alongside with the Supreme Judge, who is His Father, then rejoice with peace. They rejoice with peace. And this is the idea for this Sunday. This Sunday, in all the universal churches of the Kingdom of God, we are going to be praying for those who want to receive this peace. This peace is free of charge. However, the person has to repent from their sins, from their guilt. They have to evaluate their life and say, oh my God, I confess that I am a sinner. There is no excuse to what I've done. But if you say, oh, I did this because of that, then don't come, because it's not for you. Jesus forgives those who willingly see themselves as sinners. This is the reality. He forgives those who confess, who show repentance, and they say, I did this, I did that, I made a mistake, I killed, I stole, I raped, I did something. But oh my God, I confess all that. It's not a remorse. It's not a feeling of remorse. It's repentance. A feeling of remorse, the person feels a sadness in that moment for what they did, but later on they do it again. So that doesn't count. And God knows all things. He knows that's not repentance. When it's repentance, the person makes a pact with God. I will never do that again. I will never do this again. Never again. Never again will I make that mistake again. This is repentance. They confess, they recognize their sin, and then they enter in a state of peace and rejoicing, because the Holy Spirit, who gives repentance, makes them feel peaceful. Yes, that's when the feeling comes, because they feel peace. They enter a state of peace. This is the idea for this Sunday in all the universal churches of the Kingdom of God. By the way, you can even get everything together, all the baggage, everything that is wrong, everything that you are carrying since your childhood. Perhaps you were raped by an adult that violated your innocence, and you carry that mark, that pain inside of you. Bring everything, put it in a bag, in a package, make a package, a huge package, and bring everything to the Universal Church of the Kingdom of God in order for you to be free from that, for you to place that on the altar and say, Lord, here is all of my guilt and frustrations. And from the altar will come the forgiveness, and from the altar will come the peace that you want. This Sunday in all the Universal Churches of the Kingdom of God. If you are sincere, which means if you are truthful, sincere, transparent, and you want to have peace, the perfect peace from our Lord Jesus Christ, then prepare your package for this Sunday and bring everything, and place on the altar. And you're going to see what's going to happen in your life. If you want, you can even write these things down. Everything you've done wrong that is harmful, resentment, grudges, jealousy, place everything on a paper. Make a huge list and bring to the altar this Sunday in any Universal Church of the Kingdom of God. The church will be open to receive the package of filthiness that is hindering you from having peace. But when you place that package on the altar, then peace will invade your heart, because the Holy Spirit will testify, He will confirm that Jesus paid and forgave and washed all of your guilt. And your eternal Father will give you the pleasure, the joy of peace, the Spirit of peace will come upon you, and never again you will be the same person. This Sunday in all the Universal Churches of the Kingdom of God. May God bless you all, and until then.
UCKG Helpline Call Center is open 24 hours a day, every day of the week, all year round. If you need help due to a serious problem you may be going through, if you feel that you have nowhere to turn to and desperately need someone to lend a listening ear, then we can help you. It doesn't matter who you are or what you have done, your religion or race. Your call will be answered by someone who genuinely cares about you and have your best interests at heart. We also arrange home visits or the housebound and hospital visits for anyone in great need of kindly human contact. Whether it is simply information you want or desperately need someone to talk to, we're here for you.